the basic purpose of the multiplier is the multiplication. Let's suppose Vx and Vy are the two input signal of the multiplier, then the output of the multiplier will be, suppose that is Vz. So Vz is directly proportional to Vx into Vy. Or it can be written as Vz is equal to k into Vx into Vy, where k is the scaling factor or proportionality constant. The value of that k is 1 divided by V reference, and in general we are taking the value of V reference as 10. So this is the basic definition and the output of the multiplier circuit. Now the multiplier is basically divided into three categories. One is based on the quadrants. One is one quadrant multiplier in which both the input signal must be positive. So if the value of both the input signal is positive, that means the multiplier is operating in one quadrant multiplication. If one of the input is positive but the another output is allowed to swing either in positive direction or in the negative direction, there is no any kind of the restriction in the second of the input, then that is basically operating in two quadrant multiplier. And the last one is four quadrant. So in four quadrant, both the inputs which is being applied at the input terminal of the multiplier is allowed to swing either as positive half or the negative half. So if there is no any kind of the restriction for the input signal, that may be your positive or the negative, then that means the multiplier is operating in four quadrant multiplication. So based on the quadrants, these are the three different categories of the multiplier circuit. After that, we have studied some characteristic of the multiplier and some of the application. So that was all about the last lecture. Now today we are going to study about the analog multiplication techniques, different techniques by which we can design the analog multiplier circuits. And after the completion of that multiplication technique, we will study about the application of the multiplier. So this is all about the objective of our today's lecture, and we will try to complete in your stipulated time period. So starting with the multiplier techniques. So as I already given you the notes related to the multipliers, so I think you have gone through the all the lectures which I have completed or which I am going to complete in today's lecture. So as you know, there are four different kinds of the multiplication technique. One is quarter square wave multiplier. Second is logarithmic summing technique. Third one is pulse width modulation technique. And the fourth one is variable transconductance technique. So these are the four different techniques by which we can design the multiplier, or we can say that with the help of that we can derive the expression of the multiplier. So with the help of all these three techniques, our basic aim is to calculate the value of Vz, where the value of Vz is equal to k multiplied by Vx into Vy, where Vx and Vy are the two input signal which is being applied to the input terminal of the multiplier. K is the proportionality constant and Vz is the output. So with the help of these four different types of the circuit, or these four different types of the technique, we will try to find out the relationship in between output and input. So this is the basic aim of our lecture. So first of all, starting with quarter square wave multiplier. So this is a basic block diagram of the quarter square wave multiplier. One more thing I am telling you, that this particular topic is very important related to your examination. Many times you will find the question related to analog multiplication technique. So be careful about this particular topic. So this is the block diagram of quarter square wave multiplier, where first block is the sum block. Here this one is the sum. Here this one is the difference. So sum block will produce the sum of the two input signal. So as there the two input signals are Vx and Vy, then after the summation block, output generated will be the summation of the two input signal. That means Vx plus Vy. Similarly, as this one is the difference block, so it will produce the difference of the two input signal. So similarly, here the value of Vx is the first of the input, Vy is the second input. So output generated with this block will be Vx minus Vy. So simple as it is shown into the figure. Now the squaring circuit. What is the basic purpose of the squaring circuit? Is to produce the square of the input signal which is being applied at the input terminal. So here the value of input is Vx plus Vy. Here the value of input is Vx minus Vy. So what it will produce? It will just square the input signal. So after squaring, what is the value of output? Vx plus Vy whole square, where this all the terms are squaring term. Now after square wave, you will get this. And at the output of this particular block, the value of output is Vx minus Vy whole square. Now this one is the difference. So this difference block will produce the difference of the two signal. So it would be clear from here. Now after the difference block, from the upper side, the value of input is Vx plus Vy whole square into k minus this one, k into Vx minus Vy whole square. So a plus b whole square, just simplify this, and a minus b square, just simplify this. So after this, Vx square minus Vx square will be cancelled out, Vy square minus Vy square will be cancelled out, and this is twice of Vx into Vy. This one is twice of Vx into Vy. That means four times of Vx into Vy. So this 2 to 4, and this will be cancelled out with this 4. So what is the value of output? So at the output terminal, you will get this one, k Vx into Vy. So the output of this multiplier circuit is k into Vx into Vy. So how we have generated this multiplier circuit? The multiplier circuit is to be generated with the help of one is summation block, two is square block, and the two difference block. So by using the two square, one sum, and two difference block, we can easily generate the quarter square wave multiplier or the basic multiplier circuit. So this is the basic fundamental. So as I told you, this one is our main aim. So for any kind of the circuit, our final aim is to generate the relationship in between input and output in terms of V naught should be equal to Vx into Vy. So the same output we are getting with the help of this circuit. Now similarly, second type of the analog multiplication technique is based on logarithmic summing technique. So with the help of log and summation, we are going to derive the expression of the multiplier. So how to get the multiplier output? With the help of logarithmic block and summation block. So as you can see in the figure, this one is the logarithmic block, this one also the logarithmic block, this block is anti-log block, and this one is what? This is the summation block. Okay? So as for the designing of the multiplier, we are using the logarithmic block. These are the logarithmic block and one of the summation block. That's why it is called as the logarithmic summing technique. Logarithmic summing technique. So at the upper side, the value of input voltage is Vx. When it will pass with the help of the logarithmic block, so output will be log of the input signal. That means log of the Vx. Similarly, from this particular line, the value of input is Vy. After the logarithmic of the input, output is log of the Vy. Now at the summation, this one is not negative, this is also positive. This one is also positive. Why? Because it is only the summation block. No? So it will just sum all the input which is present at the input side. So in the summation block, what is the value of input? From here, the value of input is log of Vx. And from this particular line, the value of input is log of Vy. So log of Vx plus log of Vy, that means log of A plus log of B, that will be equal to log of A into B. So log of Vx into Vy. Now after the summation, this input signal is being applied at the input terminal of anti-log. So anti-log of this, after the anti-log of this, so anti-log of log of Vx into Vy, so that will be equal to Vx into Vy. So simple is that. So with the help of the logarithmic block and the summation block, we have derived the expression for multiplier circuit. So with the help of this also we can generate the multiplier. Now the third one is pulse height width modulation technique. So the multiplier circuit here we are going to design with the help of, by using the pulse height and pulse width, and with the help of that pulse height and width we will generate the expression of the multiplier based on the area. So as shown in this particular waveform, these are the pulses, na 1 2 3, these all are the pulses. This shaded block is the area of this pulse. Now t is the width. T is what? T is the width of this pulse, and a is the amplitude or height of the pulse. A is what? A denotes the height, and t denotes the width. And what is capital T? This capital T denotes the area. So area is nothing but length into breadth. So a multiplied by t. So t is equal to what? A into t. So let the value of this vx is equal to kx into a, where kx, ky, kz, these all are the scaling factor. These all are the scaling factor. So vx is equal to kx into a when we are calculating the height. Vy will be equal to ky into t when we are concentrating the width. And similarly vz is equal to kz into capital T. Vz is what? Vz is equal to kz into capital T. Or what is the value of this T? T is nothing but the multiplication of A into a small t. So it can be written as kz into capital A into a small t. It can be replaced by A into a small t. So vz can be written as kz into A into t. What is the value of A? A is equal to vx divided by kx. It can be written as vx divided by kx. Now similarly it can, t can be written as vy divided by ky. So by the same way we are going to derive the value of vz. So vz is what? Vz is equal to kz into t, where t is being replaced by a into a small t. Now substitute the value of this a into t from here. From here, we are deriving the value of, or we are substituting the value of a into t. So what is the value of a? A is vx divided by kx. Vx divided by kx. Now what is t? T is equal to vy divided by ky. T is what? Vy divided by ky. And already the value of kz is present. So it can be written as kz divided by kx into ky multiplied by vx into vy. But the ratio of kz divided by kx and ky, these all are the scaling factor. That means these all are the constant. So it can be written as k. It can be written as k. So k multiplied by vx into vy. So what is the value of vz? Vz is equal to k into vx into vy, which is the expression of the multiplier circuit. So by changing or modulating the value of height and width of the pulse, we can also generate the expression of the multiplier. Now the last one is variable transconductance technique. Last one is variable transconductance technique. So by changing or varying the value of transconductance, how can we generate the value of multiplier equation? What is the basic theme? By varying the value of transconductance. Transconductance, that means the value of this GM. GM is called as the transconductance. The value of, by varying the value of this transconductance, we are going to generate the expression of multiplier circuit. So what is the name of this figure? This is basically Q1 and Q2 is a differential amplifier. Already we have studied in unit number 2 what is differential amplifier. So Q1 and Q2 is the differential amplifier, where Vz is the terminal, where basically we are calculating the value of output. And as it is shown from here, base terminal of Q1 is connected to Vx. Similarly, Q2 is also connected to the input supply Vx. That's why it is called as dual input balanced output type differential amplifier. Dual input, balanced output differential amplifier. Now at the emitter terminal of this differential amplifier, one more transistor Q3 is connected, and the emitter terminal of Q3 is connected to emitter resistance RE, where actually we are calculating the value of IEE. So this will help us to derive the expression for multiplier output. So by calculating the value of this IE, what will be the value of this IE? IE is equal to VY. Here the value of what? Value is VY. Base to emitter terminal voltage is VBE. Here the value of voltage is what? VBE. And this terminal is connected to ground or zero. So it can be written as VY minus VBE minus this zero divided by RE. What is the value of IEE? IEE is VY minus VBE divided by RE. So from there we can calculate the value of RE. Why I am telling you this? Why? Because for the generation of the expression of the multiplier circuit, we will use this. So what is the value of VJ? VJ is equal to GM into R into VX. This is the value of output. I am not going to the complete derivation of this. Just simply note it down here. The value of VJ is what? VJ is equal to GM into RL into VX. And how can we write the value of transconductance? Transconductance is nothing but the value of current divided by thermal voltage. Emitter current divided by thermal voltage. So IEE divided by VT. Why? Because the emitter terminal current is what? Emitter terminal current is IEE. So IEE divided by VT, where VT is thermal voltage. Now substitute the value of IEE from here. So GM will be equal to VY minus VBE divided by RE. So now what is the value of this VY? What is the value of VY? So VY is nothing but the voltage drop across this emitter resistance. VY is what? Voltage drop across the emitter resistance plus base to emitter terminal voltage. Plus base to emitter terminal voltage, this to this terminal voltage. So by adding the value of this emitter terminal voltage plus base to emitter terminal voltage, that will be equal to your VY. Or if the value of RE into IE is much greater than the value of base to emitter. Why? Because the value of RE is in kilo ohms and the value of voltage at the base to emitter terminal of the transistor will be approximately 0.7 to 0.8 volt. So the voltage drop across this emitter resistance will be much higher as compared to 0.7. So it can be written as VY is equal to RE into IEE only. When we are neglecting the value of VBE, if the value of RE into IE is much greater than VBE, why it's much greater than? Why? Because the value of RE is high. So VY is equal to RE into IE. Or from equation number one, let's suppose this is equation number three. Now, from last slide, what is the value of this VJ? VJ is equal to GM into RL into VX. GM into RL into VX. Now, what is the value of this GM? Already we have calculated the value of GM. GM is equal to IEE divided by VT. Now, so IEE divided by VT. That is the value of GM. Let me write it here. GM is equal to IEE divided by VT. Now, this is your VX. This one is your RL. This one is your VT. Now, what is the value of IEE? From there, you can calculate the value of IEE. IEE is what? IEE is equal to VY divided by RE. From this particular equation, what is the value of IEE? IEE is VY divided by RE when we are neglecting the value of base to emitter terminal voltage. So this is your VY and this one is your IE. So from there we have derived the expression for VJ. So let it clean. What is the value of VJ? VJ is equal to RL divided by VT into RE into VX into VY. But for a particular circuit, the value of RL is constant. The value of emitter resistance is also constant. And for a particular circuit, the value of these resistances are fixed. VT is also constant. So these terms can be written as K. This can be replaced by a term K. So K into VX into VY. That is the value of VJ. So again, we have derived the expression for the output of multiplier circuit using variable transconductance technique. So these are the four different methods by which we can generate the multiplier circuit. First one is square wave multiplier circuit. Second one is